attempting that backflip, but there we are. It's great to see you.
Welcome to a special Blue Peter. Special as Blue Peter always is, but more so because we're going to be revealing the winning design from our painter plane competition.
Oh, special, yes, but yeah. It did leave us with a bit of a problem because a 757 aircraft is nearly 13 metres high, it's 38 metres wide and 48 metres long. However, the Blue Peter studio doors are just 5.5 metres high and 4.5 metres wide. You can get a dinosaur, a lorry, a double-decker bus into the studio and even an oversized supermarket trolley. But can you get an aeroplane through the doors? Well, no.
Yes, tricky, and quite frankly, we could stay here for the rest of the evening working out a way to get the plane in here.
Yes, we could discuss it at great length. That is if we were in the studio. If,
yes.
But...
Well, if the plane couldn't come to us, we thought, why don't we go to the plane? And here we are. What a bargain, everyone.
Look at that. For one show only, we're coming to you live from the North Hangar at London's Heathrow Airport. What a place. It really is. Massive.
Yes. It is a vast expanse of space. It measures 84 metres by 102 metres. It's over 36 metres high. And that makes it more than five times as big as the largest studio that we could have been in today. And it also means that that plane over there looks positively tiny. It's like a little toy.
Teeny weeny plane.
Now, Heathrow Airport is the world's busiest international airport. Over 85 airlines fly 64.3 million passengers a year to over 180 destinations. That is greater than the total population of the United Kingdom.
It is an amazing place, and 71,000 people work here. There are 12,000 luggage trolleys, 1,200 toilets, 8,000 CCTV cameras, and around about 53 travelators. It really is a city within a city.
It is indeed, and a fabulous place to welcome the winners of our Painter Plane competition. And we have got a lovely welcome for them, because here is Britain's most successful cheerleading team. It's the Ascension Eagles. Nicole, Grace and Holly, down they come looking absolutely delighted to be here. Come on in. Ron's done a lovely job driving them through. Cheers for that. Lovely. Hold there and welcome to Heathrow. Here you come. Down you come, girls. Lovely stuff. Now then, how are you? Oh, all right. Did you have a safe journey? It's lovely to see you. Now, first of all, Nicole, we're going to talk to you because you were the winner of our sevens and under category. You've done a super picture here. Did you come up with a few designs before you sent it in?
No.
Well, it's just straight off the bat, this one. It's beautiful, isn't it? We really like that one. And then we're going on to Grace. Grace, this is great. This really, really superb. You must have been delighted when you heard that you won your category.
I was like jumping around the room.
Yeah, I love this. Some beautiful painting as well. It's very nice indeed. And then we're going on to our winner, Holly. Here it is. How are you? You must be very excited, tell us. Yeah, you must be excited, are you?
Yeah.
Looking forward. We really loved your picture. We think it's so intricate and we think that it's going to look absolutely fabulous on the side of our plane. Now, Connie, what do you reckon?
Oh, it's going to look absolutely stunning. We're all very excited over here. The Ascension Eagles cheerleaders are getting ready to cheer like mad, aren't you?
Yes.
But Hayley, I was wondering, could you do with a few more people on your team, perhaps?
We could. I mean, there's not very many of us, so we could do as
many. Yeah, I mean, the more the merrier when you're unveiling something like that, don't you think?
Definitely.
Well, I've got a few mates. Come in, boys. They are the engineers from North Hangar. Do you reckon you could teach them a few moves?
Well, we'll give it a go.
Give it a go. Should be fun.
I think they're certainly outdoing you on the colourful vest out front. But Kaylee, have you ever worked with such a handsome group of men?
I can't say that I have, but now I get to, so I'm lucky.
Great. I can't wait for you to get your pom-poms, lads, in just a while. Now, Holly's plane behind us is ready for takeoff tomorrow. But earlier this week, I joined airside operations here at Heathrow Airport to see what it takes to get a plane ready for takeoff.
Come fly with me, let's fly away.
Many of you will have taken a flight when you're off on holiday and the journey starts at the check-in.
New York, please. Now, unfortunately, I'm not actually going to New York today, but have you ever wondered what happens in between you handing in your bag and you actually getting on the plane? Well, I am about to find out.
Airlines usually ask passengers to arrive at the airport a couple of hours before the flight.
That's because it takes around 2 hours to clean, refuel, and prepare a Boeing 777 for its next flight. I wish that I could fly into the sky. Andy is responsible for managing Heathrow's two runways, and he has to make sure that every plane that lands is parked up correctly. And Andy, that is a huge amount of planes, isn't it?
One plane lands every 1.5 minutes, landing and departing 1,200 a day. It's quite a number.
The plane we were going to be servicing was bound for New York in 2 hours' time. Firstly, I had to make sure it was parked in exactly the right spot. Just after the plane parks up, a whole team of people springs into action. I've been watching, I've
been waiting. This one looks as though it's nearing the end of its life, this one.
No, it's still got plenty of work.